Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate video, guys. And today I'm going to be going over the best players I believe to power up. Now, there's multiple ways that I went about picking these players. Obviously, some are going to be obvious. I mean, I can't really help that because obviously some are just beyond obvious. Now, others are guys that I just think that have better longevity than others, guys. But before we get into today's video, if you haven't already, I've dropped back-to-back bundle pack openings. I also dropping another one at 145, which isn't a bundle pack opening, but it is some packs, and it was an amazing pull. So if you guys haven't checked that out already, go check it out. Pulled some 88s. Now, guys, before I get into this video, make sure to like the video. I'll be giving away 15K in this video. Like, I'm going to start doing this again like I did last year. I'll be giving away 15K per video. All you got to do is like the video and comment down below 15K. If we hit 75 likes in this video, I'll give away 15K to a random commenter. So all you got to do is comment so I can verify it. Now, also, guys, if you could so kindly go over and drop, go hit the sub button, the noti button. If you're a fan of the channel, if you're new, drop it down below. I'm going to be grinding out 3 to 5 videos per day for a few months at least, minimum. And then all the way to the end of Madden, obviously. But 3 to 5 a day is going to be at least for the first month or so. So I'm going to be grinding a lot. So if you guys want to see your daily Madden content, you guys want to see a bunch of crap, I'd recommend you go and sub. It'll mean a lot to me, guys. Now, let's get into this video. So I'm going to go over to my collections, show you guys what I got going. I got a lot of crap already. I got a lot of players. But first ones first for me is Patrick Mahomes. I think he's an awesome guy to power up. Obviously, though, here's the issue with powering up right now. Powering up right now is a bit expensive because power-ups are... There's less people playing the game right now, in essence. So there's like every card is like the best cards, at least, have maybe 6 of their power-ups even on the block. For like, they're going for like 25-30K. So I have some pretty good advice for you guys. I sold all my power-ups. Sold Pat Pete for like 30K yesterday. Sold a bunch of power-ups for really expensive. And like you guys know, these power-ups will only be going for like 5-10K max, the good ones. Besides some other, there's a few that will always be expensive. But anyways, guys, Pat Mahomes is easy, right? First off, he's a cover of the game. Everyone wants Mahomes. I wanted Mahomes. I just bought him, actually. I really wanted this Mahomes. He gets bazooka chem. Great stats. He's partially mobile. I really like this card. Now, what I plan to do with him is he's going to be a great quarterback all year. This year isn't just scrambling. There's a good amount of pocket passer ability in this year's game because there's superstar abilities for them, obviously. There's going to be the Vic, obviously. But last year, two of the greatest quarterbacks to have were Pat Mahomes and Vic. So there's no Vic right now, so I'm definitely going to be powering up Mahomes at some point. So I think he's definitely on this list, one of the guys that, if you guys want a Mahomes, power his ass up. Because you don't want to power up a guy, let's say Levante David, right? A guy that's kind of slow, he's okay. Like, you don't want to just power up your day one team. Because if you do so, you cost money to unpower them up. And on top of that, you lose a lot of money powering people up and you lose training. So like a guy like Levante David, you probably won't use all year. Probably not going to be an end game middle linebacker. You want to get end game cards. So I see Mahomes as end game now. My second guy, who could have been, I'm not ranking these in any order, but if there was an order, it'd probably be Tyreek Hill first. Tyreek Hill is usually the fastest wide receiver up until 99 start dropping. He will be up there as the most glitchy card up until then. So you're going to have this guy as one of the most glitchy cards for 3 quarters of this game. He is the number one, hands down, best card to power up. As soon as I can get an up, but his power up's like 80K right now. I'm going to see if I can pull that. I pulled it last year, so hopefully I can pull it again because I'm not trying to buy that right now. But 89 speed, that is glitchy if you think about it. Watch this. So you guys want to look? Zach Ertz, a top tight end, 74 speed. Let's say, who's going to defend him? A middle linebacker, Levante David, 77 speed. This guy on a drag over the middle on a linebacker is going to destroy the hell out of him. Tyreek Hill's going to be one of the glitchiest cards all year round. If you have to power up one guy and that's all you had coins for, I'd do Tyreek, but don't do it yet. Wait. Just wait until the game comes out and cards start dropping and they start doing maybe some training solos. You can get some training. Just wait. It's not worth it right now, in my opinion, because it's just way too expensive. Now, would I power up DeAndre Hopkins and Brady? No. Two reasons. First off, as much as I love Hopkins, I mean, Hopkins is Nat. So would I power him up? Yes. Should you power up? Probably not, because DeAndre Hopkins typically isn't an endgame receiver. I mean, maybe this year, but he's always up on the slower side. The endgame receivers, you know, the usual. Randy Mosses, Calvin Johnson, Tyreek Hill, Keyshawn Johnsons, you know, those big-ass guys, Odells. It's never really DeAndre Hopkins. Although, maybe they'll show him a little more love this year, but they always make him a little slow. But this card is actually crazy good. You see those stats? I'm going to probably power him up because I do have him Nat. I can't get rid of him or anything, so I'll probably just end up keeping him for the most part. I mean, obviously I'm going to keep it. I might end up powering him up. Now, Tom Brady, he's never an endgame quarterback. He's too slow, and this is a game where pass rush is pretty crazy. So you want at least a semi-mobile guy. I'm going to use him. Still an awesome quarterback for the first month. him or Mahomes haven't decided yet. I'll probably end up selling Brady. I mean, Mahomes is going to be probably the better one for me. But until then, I definitely power Mahomes to Tyreek Hill. And let's keep continuing on. So, Jamal Adams, guys, is a guy that I'd probably power up. His stats are crazy good. These stats are... I mean, Jamal Adams was my endgame safety last year. Look at it. He's like the perfect hybrid. Most safeties, if they're fast and they have zone, they're not good at other things. Or if they're fast and they have hit power, they can zone. Or if they're slow with zone and hip power. But look, he is fast with an 82 speed, an 81 Excel. He has 85 play rec, 80 zone coverage, and 86 hip power. If you can chem them up just like last year, and he gets his next card is easily going to have, with chemmed up, like 86 speed, which is going to be crazy fast at this point in the game. He might have a 90 play rec, a 90 hip power, and an 85 zone. This card's going to be one of the top safeties in the game year-round, in my opinion. And he's just getting started. If he has a really good year, he can have a lot of team of the weeks. A lot of upgrades, defensive player of the year. There's a lot of potential for this guy, so I'm definitely liking him as one of my power-up guys. Now, boys, if this wasn't obvious enough, Aaron Donald's obviously on this list. He's going to be, his stats are crazy. He's going to be a top right end all year. I'm not going to go too in-depth on the obvious ones because it'd be a waste of time. Aaron Donald's definitely a top one, as is Khalil Mack, who should be right here down here on this list too. Khalil Mack and Aaron Donald all year long going to be two of the most dominant and pass rushers, I should say, not ends, because they do have Khalil Mack as an outside linebacker, which I don't really like here. They do have him there. These guys are going to be so crazy dominant. I wish I could get them. I should have bought them when they were a little cheaper. They have went up in price a ton now. But, guys, they're going to be crazy. If you guys have them and you plan to keep them and you don't plan to sell them and you can somehow get those power up, by all means, go ahead and do that. Another guy, boys, is Jadeveon Clowney. You guys already know. If you guys have played Madden any year before this, you know Jadeveon Clowney every year is going to be the prototypical hybrid linebacker. He can hit. He can decently cover. He can block shed, he can pass rush, he's going to be fast as hell, and he's going to be tall as hell. So Jadeveon Clowney is always kind of a glitch on Madden. His base stats aren't exactly amazing just yet, but everything's good, just not his speed. His speed's a little bit on the slow side, but we both know when his next card comes out, he's going to be crazy. He's going to have a high speed. He's going to have already breaking 90 play rec. He's probably going to have close to good shit. I mean, his block shed's a little low for this card, but obviously, I guess I don't want to make him too glitchy off the rip. All right, boys, next on this list is Saquon Barkley, the best running back in the league. Might be a little biased. I'm a Giants fan, but there's multiple reasons why I picked him. I went through all the running backs, and the one that I see the best potential for the best power-up all year is probably Saquon Barkley for multiple reasons. First off, he's going to have everything. Like, there's some running backs who are, like I love Le'Veon Bell, don't get me wrong, but Madden really does not show love to his stats. They always make him slow with a decent truck. Decent catching, decent route running. They really don't show love. If you're going to make them slow, let's give them like 85 catching, 85 route running, but they don't. But Saquon's going to have it all. Look at this car right now. You power this thing up and you chem it up. 84 speed once you power it up. Going to have almost 90 agility, high carrying already, and he's almost at a 90 break tackle, 84 Excel. His next card could easily be like an 86 speed, 87 speed, with a 90 break tackle, a 90 agility, and a high Excel. Plus, his trucking's even low on this card. And we both know that's going to go up. And his strength, I think, is a little low, too, if you look at it. His strength's only 72, which isn't low for a running back, but it's low in general. So this card towards the end of the year is going to be one of the strongest, fastest, He is a pass catcher, too. 68 catching, that's easily going to be high 70s pretty soon. This card alone is going to be one of the most dominant all-rounded running backs. And I looked at the other ones, like Zeke will be right there too. Obviously, Zeke's going to be one of the other ones, but Zeke's a lot more expensive. So I feel like Saquon fits the list a little better. He's a little cheaper, a little easier to obtain, and he's in the level of packs. In the level 21 pack, you get his free Saquon Barkley if you want it. So I feel like he fits the bill perfectly. He's a very budgety type guy that you could take, and he's going to be probably the best one. Todd Gurley's good, but he's too expensive. Melvin Gordon's all right, but I see Saquon, and EA clearly showed they show a lot of love to Saquon with new cards. So he's gonna get his fair share of cards, and he's going to be a great guy to power up all year. Plus, his abilities he could get. I'm not entirely sure what he can get yet, but once we know that, going to be an awesome, awesome running back. And last, you guys already know, Jalen Ramsey. He is a stud cornerback. He is every year on the top five for the power of every single year. He's always at the same price, though. He's always between 200 and 500K. He never comes down from that. This guy's stats are pretty good for a quarterback off the rip. So he's an 89 press, 88 man, 86 zone. This corner's insane. If you chem him up, if it's the same way as last year, put some lockdown on all your players, he'll have over a 90 press, a 90 man, and just below a 90 zone. He'll meet all the thresholds on his base card, and his speed's already an 83, and his jumping's an 85. This card, he might be the best cornerback in the game right now, right off the rip. It is crazy what he has. Sorry, I haven't seen the smiles. It's Josh Allen yet. But anyways, Jalen Ramsey, crazy good card. It's actually unreal to give him that good of stats off the rip, and they made him kind of fast. I thought that at least make him a little slower. And he's tall too. What's he? 6 foot. 6 foot one. Yeah. This is easily the best cornerback in the game. Him and Marshawn Lattimore. Marshawn Lattimore's more athleticism. Jalen's more lockdown. But guys, that is about it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys make the right decisions here. These are obviously my opinions, but I plan to upgrade most of those guys once I have enough coins. I obviously have a ton of coins already. Obviously, and I know before someone comments something dumb, it says 171K, but my team is well worth over a million coins. In quarterbacks alone, I have like 400K. Plus wide receivers, I have like another 300K. I have a lot of coins right now, so I could do it, but it's not worth it. I'm going to wait till the game settles, and the opening night bundle happens is when I'm going to probably buy a lot of my cards. Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you're new to the channel, make sure to drop a like and a sub. Let's get 75 likes so I can drop 15K to a random commenter. Don't forget to comment and make sure to sub. Let's get the momentum going for this channel, boys. Let's get it. I'm out. See you guys in the next video.